Action Wrestling, the most exciting hour in television. And we open with tremendous action in the ring as Pistol Pez Wadley and David Dellinger go at it at the bell, Johnny Weaver.
Yes, sir, Bob, and the Pistol Man is smoking. Pistol Pez Wadley, a great amateur athlete. He's got a record in amateur wrestling as long as your arm. Two-time state, Tennessee state champion at the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga. And he's made quite a respectable showing for himself as a professional wrestler. Really respected.
We've got a jam-packed crowd here in the Coliseum, Johnny. And they're already into the action in the ring as Wadley and Dellinger high to the air for the slam. And let's mention at the beginning of the program, all of our fans saw just a little bit of tape of a match for the United States Heavyweight Championship with Wahoo McDaniel and the new champion, Melvin T.A. We're going to show them how that new champion came about a little later on.
That's right. We've got that match on tape for you, and you're not going to miss it because it's going to be right here in this hour as we watch the Pistol Man go to work on David Dellinger. And Pistol Pez Wadley, when he's got bullgum gun smoking, he's one of the best in the ring today. Appearing on national TV here, Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. I know the Pistol Man is looking for some of those belts too because they're changing hands so fast. It's just the competition is so great that them belts are hard to hang on to. We got new world tag team champions in Ivan and Nikita Kreshia, Ivan and Nikita Koloff. We have a new TV champion and Dusty Rhodes, the Mid-Atlantic nice. Champion is new. That's Buzz Tyler, and now the United States Heavyweight Championship has changed hands. Magnum T.A., the proud possessor now. Of course, he defeated a really rugged individual.
Oh, an outstanding champion, no doubt. And Wahoo McDaniel, Magnum T.A., just shows you what caliber of athlete he is to come away with that championship. In the ring, we get a break as Wadley backs away. You're talking about all of those belts changing hands, Johnny, as the action in the ring continues as Wadley's got the headlock. We've still got a world heavyweight champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, but there's another Nature Boy that's kicking up a little fuss.
I see quite a bit of controversy and throwing out a lot of insults, not only to Flair, but a lot of other people.
We're talking about Nature Boy Buddy Landell. We'll be seeing him right here during this hour. Dellinger right to the throat for a moment there on Pez Wadley. Wadley decided it'd be better to get to his feet out to the center of the ring. And it's going to be carried to the ropes by Dellinger. Also during this hour, you're going to see the Boogeyman, the boy from New York City, Jimmy Valiant. We've got tag team action with the world champions, or at least one half of them, Ivan Koloff and another partner in Crusher Khrushchev. So we're going to have tag team action with them, and we've got six-man tag team action also during this hour, Johnny.
I understand later in the program you're going to be able to talk to number one Paul Jones, who's got a cast on his arm from his shoulder down to his fingertips.
And I'm looking forward to that one. Dellinger with a power slam, and him covered with a press. Wadley very alertly and quickly kicks out on the count of one by the referee. Headbutt, that may have turned his lights out. The Pistol Man is smoking.
Pistol Pez Wadley in complete control of the match. It has been since the opening bell. We indicated he's really gained a lot of respect from all his peers in the wrestling profession.
Still with Dellinger out to the center of the ring. He helps him up to his feet again and backs him to the rope. Still on the attack, Johnny, as he's got Dellinger in the ropes.
They're going to slug it out. Now it's Dellinger with the upper hand. Good counter by Wadley. Flying headbutt hit the mark. That could be it, Bob.
He's got that leg hooked. Got him covered with a press. And the quick count of three from Pistol Pez Wadley, our winner. And what an opening match, fans. And the action and excitement as Wadley comes on as our winner. Johnny, watch it here in slow motion.
There's the Pistol Man getting ready to deliver that flying headbutt that he's got patented. And it hits the mark. Down goes David Dillinger, the winner of the match. Pistol Pez Wadley.
All right, fans, right here ringside with us, Sam Houston, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty?
You know, Bob, I thank you for this television time that we're taking right here, and I'd like to ask Sam Houston a couple questions. Sam, how old are you?
19, sir.
19 years old. Why did you want to be a professional wrestler?
Professional wrestling to me is the greatest sport in the world. I've grown up around it, and all my life I've wanted to be the NWA heavyweight champion, world heavyweight champion.
Take your hat off a minute. I want to show you something, Bob Cowley. I want to get a shot of this head right here. What happened to your head, Sam?
Dusty, don't worry about it. It's nothing.
Yeah, it is something. Yeah, it is something. Tully Blanchard, you take a look at this kid's head right here. 24 stitches. 24 stitches in his head. It is something to me. Now, my old noggin is rugged. I've had a many of them put in there. He came down just recently to help me out. Baby doll tossed in the bracelet from around her wrist, and you laid this kid wide open. Now then, let's talk about getting down to business. You're talking about barbed wire. You're talking about bull ropes and bunkhouses. Well, let's get it on. Let's stop talking about it. Let's stop being about it. 19 years old. 19 years old, Daddy. Let me tell you something, Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll. This kid's gonna be a champion someday. I want Sam Houston everywhere I go to be in my corner, to be with me. And Sam, if Baby Doll gets anywhere out of line, I want you to spank her honey, and he can do it. So let's talk business, Tully Blanchard. Let's me and you talk business. This ain't some half-witted, shaved, half-head movie star that comes on the scene and all the publicity going around the world is talking about. This is real life. This is real life. This is professional wrestling. And I am the National Wrestling Alliance television champion. Now then, you're gonna have to deal with me. And Sam Houston, let me tell you something, Daddy. If you're big star bound, it's a long, hard ride. And I'm gonna take him with me from now on, baby.
Dusty Rhodes, Sam Houston. We'll be right back after we take this time out. Fans, it's a real honor and a pleasure to introduce this young man right here, Magnum T.A., like this. The United States Heavyweight Champion. Congratulations, Magnum.
Well, thank you very much. You know, it was about 3 months ago when I was standing in a very similar spot like this when I came out here and told all the people out there that I was coming here to take the United States Heavyweight Championship. And all those people out there believed in me and stood behind me. And it was a long, hard road, but it all paid off right here. I went through some of the toughest battles of my life, and the toughest one yet was when I walked in that steel cage with Wahoo McDaniels. I knew what I had coming after me. I knew I was fighting a legend, but I knew that if I had faith in myself, just like all those people out there, when it came right down to it, I could come out victorious. And it's all right here. The United
Magnum, you did. And talking about coming out victorious, we've got some tape of some of the final minutes of that match, that championship match with Wahoo McDaniel and his, as you said, that cage around the ring. And here you are in action with the Chief.
As you can see here, we've both taken a tremendous amount of punishment. The Chief's got me in a lot of trouble right here. We've been wrestling for about 20 minutes. Exhaustion set in, making all over. I know I've got to keep going, but those people out there are driving me on. They're not letting me give up because they're not losing any faith in me, and they're keeping me in the fight right here. I'm in a tremendous amount of pain, but I'm trying to rally my strength back. I'm trying to get my wits back about me so I can come back on Wahoo McDaniels. He's trying to crowd me in that corner. I'm coming back on him with the kicks. I finally knocked him off his feet. It gave me a little bit of room to get some air, get the breath back, get my head cleared up. But you can't stay back from the Chief too long. You got to stay on. You got to stay on with the attack. And I'm taking the fight to him right here. But right here, you see Wahoo McDaniels climbing up those ropes because he's going up there trying to get out of this cage. But I'm not letting him out now. I've come too far right now in this battle to let him get away from me. I got him back with that back suplex, and I'm going for the cover right here. I think I got a chance of taking him out right here, but the Chief still had a little too much fight left in him. He kicks out of that. I've got to get back on him. I know I can't slack up for a minute, and the Chief hit me with this big chop here, just about put my lights out, but I was able to get my foot over the rope, and I'm still in it right here this time. I know I'm in a lot of trouble. I know that I can't let the man keep on attacking me in this way, or I'm not going to be able to hold out. He's hit me with some very, very vicious blows. He's just about to knock me to unconsciousness, but those people are still right there. I've still got my senses. I got my foot over the rope one more time. This man has got to be the roughest competitor I've ever been against in my life. He's like a machine out there. Now he's coming off. He hit me with a big tackle. I'm almost down right here, but this is where I caught him right here. He thought he had me. He was overconfident, and I got him with that belly-to-belly suplex.
Magnum, once you get it on him, and once you get it on the opponent, boy, I tell you, and there was elation all over your face. What a happy moment that had to be for you.
I want to tell the people out there, that was the happiest moment in my wrestling career. But it doesn't end here, because now the real challenge is before me. Now I have the challenge to try to be the best United States heavyweight champion the people have ever seen, and that's my goal.
Magnum, talking about being the champion, there's a lot of people after that championship belt. And speaking of being after it, there's one in a ring that's also hot on the trail. And here he is, the Nature Boy, Buddy Landell himself.
No, Buddy Landell, very flamboyant individual. He's trying to make his name off Ric Flair, a man that has proven time and time again that he is the Nature Boy. He's the NWA heavyweight champion. Now, I have respect for athletes because I think he showed himself as an athlete in the ring. But his cockiness is something that I just can't swallow right now.
All right, the Bell fans, and we're ready to go with the match right here. Landell comes out, Johnny. He comes out of that corner ready to go.
Magno spoke of his cockiness, and he's sure showing that now. You know, he's really read that mouth off. And Magnum, can't you foresee a confrontation between Flair and Buddy Landell? I mean, this guy's saying he was the original Nature Boy, the one and the only. And sometimes you know yourself, when you talk like that, them words sometimes are hard to digest.
You know, it's real easy to talk, and you can talk a good fight, but sometimes it comes to put up or shut up. Buddy Landell is yet to prove himself with a seasoned veteran. He's looking real good in there against this inexperienced young man, but this man's got a lot of good years ahead of him. He's right there. That tells the tale. The man gets very overconfident. He thinks he's got everything under control, but he didn't.
Don't you think that Jim Dillon, J.J. Dillon, we all know that what a devious man he is and what a mind he has, had to see something extraordinary in Buddy Landell to put him in his camp. Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
I'm sure that J.J. Dillon saw a lot of potential in Buddy Landell, but what J.J. Dillon also sees is people that he can manipulate, people that he can lull into some kind of sense of confidence in himself, thinking that he is one of the greatest managers in the world. Well, he's a very devious man. He doesn't mind what kind of tactics he uses, and obviously Buddy Landell falls right in that same mold.
Johnny, he has really been taking about to Mark Fleming. He has Fleming on the mat now, and he's been punishing Fleming since the opening bell.
Well, we've saw him three or four times in Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. Nature Boy Buddy Landell came out with J.J. Dillon. Every time he's looked more impressive. You can see a little more of Dillon rubbing off on Buddy Landell in his matches. And I'll tell you, he walked out tonight. He electrified the crowd here in this auditorium like Ric Flair has in the past.
He's a man with a great deal of confidence. That you say, like Ric Flair has in the past, it's easy to imitate somebody, but to duplicate that particular charisma, that kind of excitement, that's something that this man's a long way from doing.
And it's coming out of his mouth that he's the original and Flair is a duplicate.
Well, as I said, talk's cheap, but when it gets right down to it, one way or the other, this whole issue is going to have to be settled in that square circle, because that's the only place that it can be settled, not in an argument.
It's amazing, too. We've seen him on several matches now. He's always been successful. He always mastered that figure four and put the men away with a figure four, and Flair has done that.
The man's got a tremendous wrestling background. You can see he stays on his opponent. He keeps through the hold. He starts working one part of the body, and he's staying on it here. And, yes, you say he uses the figure four. Well, I haven't seen him put anybody out in contendership with that figure four as of yet, but I know he has been successful with it in a few matches he's had here since being in the Mid-Atlantic area.
Hey, he's going to go to it right now, looks like, Johnny. Look at that, Magnum.
Well, it looks like he knows what he's doing. He's trying to execute the save, trying to rush himself here. Now he's got it locked in. If that had been a more experienced man, he could have possibly turned that to his advantage. He's gotten out of the hole.
Well, there it is, Johnny. He got him with a figure four.
And the winner of the match, Nature Boy, Buddy Landell. Figure four leg lock, Mark Fleming forced to concede.
Yeah, Magnum, we just saw Nature Boy Buddy Landell with a win in a ring with a figure four, imitating again the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Well, I have this to say about Buddy Landell, Nature Boy as he calls himself. You know, he took it upon himself the night that I won the title to come in and interrupt a very special moment for me. a moment when I was in a great deal of celebration. Well, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, if you want a piece of me and a piece of this belt, I'm not real hard to find. Just put your name on that dotted line. Don't have to be talking nothing. Just put your name on the dotted line and crawl in that square circle with me. Because what I am is a fighter. I'm a fighter defending this belt. And when you want a piece of this belt, that means you want a piece of me. And you don't have to make no mince words about it. Just say you want a piece of me and don't bring nothing else into it.
Magnum, talking about that meeting, we have a tape of that. Nature Boy Buddy Landell, Magnum TA in the dressing room. Let's watch it.
Oh, it's finally over. The battle, that greatest battle ever in my life, right there. I've never been so close to want to give up my life. Those people out there, they're good as gold, brother. Those people help me win that victory.
We don't want no trouble. We don't mean any trouble. I just want to be the first one to come in here and to offer my congratulations, sincere congratulations, because it took a heck of a man to beat a legend like Wahoo McDaniels and put his shoulders down. You deserve to be the United States champion. But my man, the Nature Boy, has a little something he wants to say to you.
I just want to congratulate you. You're a heck of an athlete. You beat a heck of a legend. Speaking of legends, brother, I've heard you've been seen around town with a beautiful young lady. And when she wakes up from this fantasy, brother, and she gets tired of playing with boys and she wants a real man, why don't you give her the Nature Boy's card, brother?
What are you doing to me right now? Hey, French boy!
Get him out of here!
Nature Boy!
Get out of here!
Come on, man!
Hey!
Come in here right now! Who are you anyway?
Get him
right. This is my time. This is my day. I work for this thing.
You get him right here.
What is this? Buddy Landell, where's that belt? I fought a long time for this, brother. You, it's real easy. You call yourself a nature boy, a champion. Well, this is what a champion is all about, Daddy. You want some of me, don't you talk about my ladies. That's my personal life. But this is anybody's life that wants a piece of it. And if you, Jack, want to be the first one, put your name on the dotted line and come get a piece of me. I'm going to party with my friends.
Shoulder clear down to his fingertips. The arm was broken two places, I think, once around the thumb and once above the elbow. And the boogeyman is ready for him.
And fans, we're going to be talking with Paul Jones a little later in the program. We're going to get a chance to look at Paul and talk with him. You don't want to miss that. Look at the boogeyman going to work on Don Rossi. Boy, he comes out at the bell, and he comes out charging, Johnny. He turns it all loose.
And, Bob, that was quite a confrontation in that dressing room between Buddy Landell and Magnum T.A. Of course, Magnum, the U.S. champ now. A lot of people are going to be after that bell to put you in number one position for the world title of Ric Flair. And, of course, I'm sure Buddy Landell wants both of those belts. Other people like the superstar, 6'7", 300 pounds. Quite a man there. He's going to be after that. He made no bones about it. And he was coming here, and he wanted a shot at the U.S. belt and the world belt.
Magnum, it was a very difficult task to win that championship. Johnny, it's going to be just as hard to hang on to.
Anytime you beat Wahoo McDaniels, it's a tough task.
That's right. It's going to be just as difficult. Difficult to hang on. There's Valiant with the fingers now, right to the eyes of Rossi.
Well, that's a patented move of Jimmy Valiant. You know, the Andersons had patent moves, and other men have patented moves that they use. But, boy, I tell you what, Valiant, you never know what he's going to do. But he gets that victory. And right now, of course, Paul Jones, as we indicated, has got a cast on his arm broke in two places. but he's a shrewd manipulator in that mind of his, I'm sure, especially with the beef that he has himself surrounded with.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
He is not taking this lightly.
Johnny, you know that Paul Jones is planning and mapping and plotting something, and he's going to be coming back with something, no doubt.
Well, here is the Boogie Woogie Man. And he defeats Ron Rossi right here. Look at that. That's a great shot of the Boogie Man and his old lady.
Okay, fans, with us right here ringside, Nature Boy Buddy Landale, Arn Anderson. Arn, we keep hearing, hey, your cousin's going to be around. We keep talking about him. We haven't seen him yet.
Brother, if I tell you an inchworm can pull a freight train, you hook it up. Arn Anderson, Double A, told you one thing when I came here. I was an unknown quantity. What I had to do is get out and prove myself. Now, if I hadn't proved myself, Manny Fernandez is getting uglier every day, and his head is dying off of his shoulders because, brother, I have beat him to a pulp from pillar to post all over the place. Now, I told you Ole Anderson was on the way. My cousin is on the way. He's got some business he's got to finish up, but when he gets here, things will go from there. Now, I'm going to tell everybody out there just a few things, and I want you to listen up. I don't care if you're a truck driver. I don't care if you stack cement blocks for a living. I don't care if you bounce in a bar. I don't care if you're a biker, brother. Anybody out there that thinks they're tough on any local level, you come on down the arena, buy you a ticket, plop your plump fanny out there at ringside, brother, and I will show you what the finest wrestling machine in the business today is all about, Daddy. I'm going to tell you something, Raging Bull. I'm going to step on you, brother. I've done stepped on half your body. I'm going to step on the rest of you. I'm going on up. I'm going to get a piece of you, Rhodes. Magnum TA, you stick your nose in my business, I'll get some of you, too. I want anybody, but all I want, brother, is top competition. I'm the pain doctor. When I tell you something, you listen up, because all I got to say is I'm Double A, baby, just like Amco Transmissions. I will give you a lifetime guarantee on injury.
That's your boy, Buddy Landale.
I believe
what
brother
about
here?
Magnum T.A.?
Magnum T.A., and there's another guy going around the country trying to make a reputation off my name. I believe they call him Ric Flair. Well, let me tell you something, Flair, Magnum T.A., Raging Bull, and Dusty Rhodes, and all of you. I don't care if it's in Miami, Florida, Jacksonville, Florida, Memphis, Tennessee, Detroit, Chicago, anywhere we go, brother. The Nature Boy, Buddy Landale, is the only Nature Boy, and I'm here to make a name for myself and to make a home here, brother. Home all over the United States, that's me.
All right, we're ready for six-man tag team action right here. The LPs, and in their corner, Hollywood Johnny Tatum. The opponents across the ring, young Sam Houston, Denny Brown, and Gene Ligon, and Johnny Weaver. Earlier, we got a look at that head and that forehead of Sam Houston. I tell you, I don't think, I don't know whether a young man ought to even be in a match with that or not.
Guts of this kid. He's even going to start the match. You know, a lot of fighters I saw get split open before, they don't fight for 6 months after that. Here's a man right in there with 24 stitches in his head. What guts and desire on this Sam Houston. He's going to be a champion. He's even starting to match, and he's got two partners out there.
That's right. The RPMs now with Hollywood Johnny Tatum in their corner. The LP lifted up by Houston and slammed to the mat. Look at the young man get up with that dropkick, and he had a lot of power and force behind it. Just shows you what kind of an athlete he is.
I think he's got him confused and off guard already. They're disorganized over in that corner. This is going to be DJ get in there now. Hollywood Johnny Tatum on the outside. Quite a comfortable threesome over there, Bob. But Sam Houston is taking a fight to him. And listen to our crowd.
The full house here in the Coliseum, and they're going wild. Look at Houston right over the back. And DJ catches him in the headlock, coming back. Hollywood Johnny Tatum slammed hard to the mat.
All right, here's Denny Brown now getting a tag from Sam Houston. Denny, the World Junior Heavyweight Champion, blocks that punch.
showed you a tremendous amount of speed here in the opening moments of the match. Sam Houston and Denny Brown, they've got speed to burn, and it's really telling on their opponents.
Well, the RPMs are now on the outside. Really a colorful-looking team. They came here and made no beans about it that they wanted a tag team championship, and if they had to get the Mid-Atlantic one before they could get a shot at the world, they'd settle for that. So they're looking for titles. Oh, that's a beat by Denny Brown. Outmaneuvered. Honeywood Johnny Tatum takes it back to the mat.
Has him right back down on the mat again in a headlock. A little later, you're going to be meeting, and we're going to be talking with a former NWA TV champion, the man that held that championship longer than anybody else, Tully Blanchard. His Perfect 10 baby doll is going to be with him. Boy, I tell you, I'm anxious to see what they have to say, Johnny, as well as we're going to see Arn Anderson in action. And don't forget Buzz Tyler and Rocky Knuckle in a tag team match against the Colossus.
Having watched Tully Blanchard for a long, long time, and we see Sam Houston's hand in there, he'll probably be very boastful about that, like in a surprise position that Tully Blanchard did. 19-year-old boy.
This is Gene Ligon now, as Hollywood Johnny Tatum lifts him high to the mat, slams him hard right to the base of the neck.
Well, they found an opening in that speedy defense or offense that was thrown up at him by Sam Houston and Denny Brown, and RPMs are now trying to take their toll on Gene Ligon.
They're going to switch. LP comes in as DJ goes out. Ligon slammed hard to the mat.
With 24 recent new stitches in his head.
And Denny Brown is right back with it again.
Denny Brown knows what to do when he gets that tag get in there.
Let's see if Lincoln's going to go with the same thing. If they're going to keep it now. And they do, right back with that headlock again on LP. He's down on his knees. Well, he has taken some punishment on that head already. All three of the opponents had him in the headlock, applying the pressure.
And so far, they've had a team of Tatum and RPMs a little disorganized here. Maybe LP will slow down the tempo to see if they can't get back organized. Here's Denny Brown back in.
Ligon backed into the ropes, but Denny Brown with that forearm. Johnny, this is a good-looking young six-man tag team here.
Certainly been an action-packed match. You couldn't want any more action or a faster tempo.
He's right back again. Denny Brown is with that headlock.
A lot of fire in these young men. Action picks up once more, Bob.
Johnny, that's as hard as you've seen anybody collide. You're talking about speed. He was across that ring in about three steps.
Gene Ligon back in now. Headlock again. Uh-oh, they worked him over. No man's land. That's a place you don't want to be in a tag match.
Yes, sir. Gene Ligon, bad trouble now. Tatum's got the rope around his throat. The RPMs, both of them attack him while he's in the corner.
Hard elbow by DJ.
That one almost cut him a flip. Johnny had his feet high off of the mat.
Now there's Hollywood Johnny Tatum into the ring. Close line. Was that a close line? Caught Gene Ligon. Down he goes. And the tied up battle has certainly switched. Listen to our crowd.
After the count of one.
I think Tatum was a little confident that it was all over there too, but they surprised him and the match continues. Oh, man, right double.
of his head. Amazing as he comes out of that. Gene Liggins still alive. He needs to get a tag to either Houston or Denny Brown.
There's a knee. Three times now he's kicked out. But Johnny, if he don't make a tag soon, it could all be over for his team, and he's back in no man's land.
They got him right where they want him right now, over on that side of the ring. Beautiful drop kick, executed well by DJ.
Leading just a tremendous amount of power behind that one. Johnny, he was about 7 feet in the air when he came down with that drop kick.
Well, they haven't been able to put Gene Liggett away. He's been able to fight enough just to keep that shoulder away from three.
Well, double team, you'd every chance they get in the corner, and they have really worked the double team on Gene Liggett. Tatum, Hollywood, Johnny Tatum doing a little strutting now around the ring.
Counter for that maneuver, and there wasn't a lot left out of Gene Liggett anyway.
Again, back to the corner again for the tag as Liggett is going to be double teamed. He's reeling now as he's taking a lot of blows to the head, but look at him fight back again. The man that held the NWA TV Championship longer than any other professional wrestler in the history of wrestling, Tully Blanchard, is perfect 10 baby doll. I got to ask you about young
Bob
Sam
Cobb,
Houston.
You don't got to ask me about nothing, I'll tell you. You come out here, you sit out here with Johnny Weaver, who I slapped around 6-8 months ago like I owned him, and Weaver, you ain't no boy. Sam Houston, you stiffened your nose in the ring. You got no business coming in on the last match. It was over with. Dusty Rhodes was down, laying there, crying, no more. Please quit, Tully. Please quit. I'm hurt. You stuck your nose in. You got 24 stitches. Bob Cottle, a boy shouldn't get in the ring with a man. That Dusty Rhodes, you act like you got a deal with the dealer. Well, Dusty Rhodes, I held that title longer than anybody in the history of the NWA, and I wrestled lots of people. I put up $10,000 of my money. You can't do that. You can't go to the bank and put up 10 grand on your abilities. But Dusty Rhodes, if you got the guts, if you got the, excuse me, if you got what it takes to be a man, Dusty Rhodes, I don't care if it's bunkhouse. I don't care if it's barbed wire. I don't care if it's bull ropes. Dusty Rhodes, this is you and me. And it's coming real fine to me that professional wrestling is not big enough for you or me. Now, Dusty Rhodes, I made the television championship what it is today. Tully Blanchard did it, not you. So, Dusty Rhodes, I'm gonna take it back, and I'm gonna hurt you bad, and you're not gonna be able to wrestle anymore. Dusty Rhodes, you listen to me, and you listen real good, because I'm gonna beat you like a dog you are.
All right, fans of Bell, we're ready with more action. Arn Anderson and Rocky King. Double A, as he calls himself in that ring, Arn Anderson, Johnny. But I tell you, he's a whale of an athlete. Look at him at the bell. He goes right out to work on Rocky King, and he just pounds away at him.
Tenaciously on top of Rocky King, and no cover, but King hasn't got started, and that has been an Anderson Patton in the past for a long time. A little feud going here with Bull. The Raging Bull, of course. Arn Anderson has said a lot of bad things about the Bull. Even Pearl Harbored him a couple times. From the back, took a cheap shot a couple times at the Raging Bull. And that's a typical Anderson maneuver.
Arn Anderson, he's been on top of Rocky King since the match began. And the ring, Johnny, as you say, is hollering, where is the Bull now? But look at Rocky King trying to fight back. But Arn Anderson is such a tremendous athlete, and you can just tell by looking at him, he moves around the ring, what outstanding condition he's in.
Well, the Andersons have always been known for that. Great shape, great condition, a lot of wrestling knowledge. Oh, and it drops him out flat on his stomach. Tremendous move by Arn Anderson. Is that going to win it for him? It
is. Oh, and a very quick win for Arn Anderson over Rocky King. Hey, Johnny, he's not going to stop. He's staying right there. He's continuing to work him over.
And now goes the referee. Arn Anderson on that neck area.
He's won the match. Here comes the ball.
The Raging Bull. And the ring, he's going to get a chance. He's going to give him a chance to pay back a little bit.
The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, goes at Arn Anderson. As they slug and kick away at each other. Now we got a ring pull coming in. Here's the Avalanche. Denny Brown, Rocky Canole, and Moore now trying to get them apart.
And there's Moore in the ring. Holy cow, look at that. Look at the end of Vince in the ring. Trying to separate these two, but they won't be separated. The two of them are still after each other. There must be 12 people in there trying to keep them apart. They're still at each other.
Each other. You got about six guys each trying to pull them apart, and that's just how bad they were. Look at, here's the ball. He's got the belt.
The Bull got loose again. A dozen people trying to separate them, and they finally get the job done.
Smoking a bear, and he said the forest ain't nothing. He said the boogeyman, the forest is nothing. The fire is right here, baby. Listen at them people. Woo, mercy. You know I got my old lady with me day and night, baby. See what it says right there? Paul Jones. Or it could say Jones Paul. Whatever, brother. I love it to death. We did what we said we're gonna do, people. We hurt Paul Jones. You know, this goes all over the world, baby. I'm talking about the Windy City Bulls. Here, my main man right here, the Buzzard. The Buzzard, I love you to death. I know just you not come out here that he was gonna put one of them sugars on me. You understand?
I'm glad it was you.
The boogeyman, I know you gonna kiss me, but I love you like a brother. Let me tell you something, Daddy, what's going on. Everybody's fired up. There's a lot of happening going on. But you got to understand one thing. It's just like a big old family. You talk about the Boogie Woogie Man, Buzz Avalanche Tower, the Bull, the Dream, Magnum TA. You talking about a whole lot of friendship, a whole lot of fighting desire. Now, all of you's out there, you heed this warning right now, Daddy. Whatever you want, if it's the United States title, the Mid-Atlantic, the TV title, the Boogie Woogie Man and his old lady, then you just come and get it. Put your name on the dotted line, because all of us has got that open contract, and what you see is what you get. But what you don't see is better yet. Yeah. Let me tell you something. Wired up, fired up, and ready to go, baby. Get ready. 280 pounds. Rob Stump and get him. The Boogie Woogie Man. 247 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal. Yeah, daddy. That's all it is to it. Get up. Get ready. If you want us, come and get us. Because we're here to stay. Just like Ajax 2, daddy. We're going to put it on you. And nobody can take it off. The Boogie Woogie Man and his old lady is here to stay. The Dream. Magnum T.A. A boy.
The Avalanche, Buzz Tyler, Mid-Atlantic champion. Rocky Kernodle in his corner. And across the way, we got two-thirds of the six-man tag team champions, the Russian Bear, Ivan Kolov. And his partner, Crusher Khrushchev.
Well, there's the newly crowned Mid-Atlantic champion, Buzz Avalanche Tyler. On the outside, Rocky Kernodle, the younger brother of Don Kernodle. Bob, there's no love lost between the Russians and the Kernodles. And that last one was a wild one, but this one can turn into be the same kind of brawl.
The Avalanche, with Ivan Kolov back to the corner, tried to whip him across the ring, and Kolov charges right into the elbow. The Avalanche, boy, he's a big one, and he packs a lot of power in there, Johnny.
Mid-Atlantic champion from South Carolina, and he's proud to represent the Mid-Atlantic area. He fought long and hard for that belt and got it away from Cowboy Ron Bass. Now he's in there with Rocky Kernodle against two big, strong Russians.
And this Crusher Khrushchev, who is a big one, he's a tall, powerful man. Got to the ropes. Now they're at the center of the ring, and Tyler again comes with a wrist.
I know Rocky Kernodle enjoys the opportunity to team with the Mid-Atlantic champion, Buzz Tyler, especially against the Russians, because so much has come down between the Russians and the Kernodle family.
All right, here's Kernodle in. The first time is a double team, Crusher Khrushchev. He's back with the arm and the wrist. They're going to stay with that hold. They had him on the arm, and they're going to keep it, Johnny.
And a tag is made, but Ivan runs right into trouble. The quickness and the ability of Rocky Kernodle keeps the match in their favor. Over the top.
He caught him with that flying press. Kolov kicked out. And the atomic drop.
Lateral press. He could have a winner right here. More than that, to put the shoulders down for the Russians, especially Ivan, the old master, the tough, rugged man that's been around a long time.
And he doesn't come by that name, the Bear, Johnny, very lightly. He is really a bear of a man in the ring. Here is Kernodle going over to get Ivan now over the top rope and slam him back to the ring. That's a long way to fall.
And now Kernodle's up there.
This right here, all brought about by the old lady of Jimmy Valiant. Here's number one, Paul Jones, with that cast on the arm, Paul.
Bob, let me tell you something. I come out here, they saw my arm, and they laughed. Well, let me tell you something. Everybody knows by now, if you don't know, you pay attention.
I hope today that they can show, yes, look right there. Whoa. I want you people to see the animal that Jimmy Valiant is. This is the man that you people stand behind, and this is the man that you agree with everything he does. But I want you to see right here where he comes in a ring with a big hickory stick, and he uses it on me. And everybody, anywhere, the man would go straight to jail, and he would be in prison today. Look right there. Look, and everybody cheers the man. Well, let me tell you something. You people know it, and Jimmy Valiant, you know it most of all. Paul Jones is not going to take this sitting down. When I was in the hospital, and I want to show you, I wish I could take it off right now. An operation here and an operation here. And Valiant, let me tell you, Superstar is out of the country right now. But when he comes back, martial arts is legal. And this man right here knows the martial arts. And Valiant, piece by piece, I'm going to take you all the way out. You can't run too far, too fast, because you're going to get it. We're going to get you, Valiant.
See you next week, fans. And until then, so long for now.